hello and welcome to our collective worship. And we're going to begin this time, as I usually do, with a prayer. And I'm going to say the word in the first line, and if you can say the words in the second line, I'll say the words in the third line, if you can say the words in the fourth. God said, let there be light. Jesus is the light of the world. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. And if you're able to, we pray together. Oh God, as we meet here, help us to remember that you are here with us, to pray to you and sing your praise with all our hearts, and to listen to your words with open ears. Amen. And can you remember what the word amen means? Yeah, it means I agree. So we're going to sing our first song. Hopefully it's a song you'll know. If not, you can pick it up quite easy. It's called We Want to See Jesus Lifted High. Friend Lulu today, and Lulu's quite excited. Why are you excited, Lulu? Oh yeah, because it's a special time of the year. And actually in the church's calendar, there's a special word, and it's this word, Advent. What does Advent mean? Well, it means to wait. It means waiting for something. Now, I don't know about you, but it may be that you have a thing called an advent calendar. Oh, you have an advent calendar, Lulu. Yes, and so there's a door for each day in December, and behind each door there's a little doggy snack. And so each day you open a door, and you have a doggy snack. Oh, I see. And then each door is open until Christmas Eve. And on Christmas Eve, you have a big doggy snack. Why does that happen? Oh, because the day after then is Christmas Day. You see, Advent is this build-up to Christmas. And I bet most of you are quite excited because Christmas is coming. I know Lulu is. I am quite as well. But Advent reminds us that we're to wait. And while we're waiting, we need to be thinking about, actually, what things do I need to think about in my relationships? Have I been kind to people? Are there people maybe I need to say sorry to? Are there things that I should have done but I hadn't and I need to do? In the Bible, we have a special verse, and it's going to come up now. This verse is from the Old Testament. It's from a prophet called Isaiah, and it says this: "The people walking in darkness have seen a great light, and those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For unto us a child is born, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." See, in those days, the people lived in very much fear. Their country had been conquered by an enemy, and everywhere was dark, and they didn't know where God was, and they didn't know what the future was going to hold. And Isaiah had this prophecy, this message from God saying, there will be a time when things will be better, when this child will be born, and he will be this wonderful person, he'll be God's son. But the people had to wait. But they always had that hope of what was to come. And in Advent, that's what we remember, this hope of what is to come. Remembering Jesus was born that Christmas day, but also remembering that one day he will come back. And so Advent is a time where we make ourselves ready for that time when Jesus will come again. And part of being made ready is making sure that we're right with God and we're right in our relationships with others, making sure that we do and say the right things and that we're sorry for the things that we haven't done. Now, we often think of Advent as this build-up to Christmas, the time where we're prepared to receive our presents. But actually, maybe Advent should be also thinking about what can we do. I'm going to watch a video now, and it's about a little boy who's waiting for something special to happen.
Good times for a change. See, the luck I've had could make a good man turn bad. So for once in my life, let me get what I need. Lord knows it would be the first time.
Interesting, wasn't it? So that little boy, of course, was waiting for Christmas Day, but it wasn't for the presents he was going to receive, it was for the present that he was going to give. And while he was waiting for Christmas Day to come, he was looking for a present, he was getting wrapping paper, he was getting it all ready, he was keeping it in that secret place. And on a Christmas morning, he walked past his own presents that he'd got just to give the present that he'd made for his parents. This Advent, while you're waiting for Christmas to come, think about what is it you can do while you're waiting. How can you do things that are going to make other people happy? How are you going to do things that, in a sense, makes God happy? We're going to sing our song, which is a prayer, Kumbaya. The word Kumbaya means, come and be with me. And for those of you who may be new to this song, it's a way of saying a prayer. It's a song which is saying to God, this is how I'm feeling, or this is how somebody else is feeling, and either come and be with me or come and be with them. We've been thinking today about waiting for hopefully something good to happen. But while we're waiting, it's good that we talk to God and say, this is how we feel. So we're going to sing, Kumbaya, my Lord, Kumbaya. Today for people who are waiting, could be for all sorts of things. Could be to hear about how somebody's doing, may not be feeling well. Could be waiting for hearing some news of loved ones, family or friends. Could be waiting to find out results about something. So however we're waiting, we're going to pray that God will be with us. So someone's waiting, Lord, come by our. Someone's waiting, Lord, come by Someone's waiting, Lord, come by Someone's waiting, Lord, come by So I really wish you a great Advent, and I hope I can see you soon. But for now, Lula and I just want to pray God's blessing on you and pray that you have a great day today and an even better day tomorrow. And hopefully some Advent doors on your calendar to open. Bye-bye.